There's a lot happening in the space, as always. For starters, you mentioned agency trading desks, and the consensus really is among all of the agency trading desks that that term will die in 2013. It doesn't really, when you think of agency trading desks, you think of pushing buttons, operating DSPs, and that's true, we do that, but what happens before we get a campaign and set a campaign live is really what is differentiating us and differentiating our clients in this new world of programmatic buying. What I mean is, before we set a campaign live, there's an immense amount of data planning and segmentation and planning around budget and investment and allocation and frequency and optimizations that happen. So it's very strategic model. What will the new term be? I don't know. Xaxis has had sort of hung its hat on audience buying. I'm not sure where the rest of the industry will go. And that actually dovetails also into what we're seeing in our conversations with publishers, but also clients. You know, RTB isn't just the race to the bottom, as publishers say. Some of them, we vehemently disagree. But it offers a lot of operational efficiencies. And I think that everyone is sort of getting on board now with regard to that. It offers, you know, indeed an auction-based buying opportunity, but also it gives us the ability to plug in to inventory sources that we otherwise don't have access to, and to be able to buy in that fashion. And what we're seeing is, you know, different types of marketplaces for premium publishers, marketplaces that you know, really protect the quality of advertisers that they see within that. And so what I'm saying is, RTB doesn't have, you know, we have the analog and the display world, and that was really a performance type of marketplace, a performance value proposition. And what we're seeing in video is it's becoming far more of a brand play. And there is that space. Our teams, the agency trading desks, we've been operating the technology for some time. We have these massive data management platforms to plug in. So really, you know, the time is ripe, and it's happening. You know, so 2013, I think we're going to see a lot of growth in the video marketplace across programmatic video. I'm not going to say RTB video, but programmatic, which is essentially the same thing. In terms of pricing, I think that there's a few ways to look at where video prices will go. On an impression, because we're using data to inform decisions about when to deliver a video ad, it may very well be that a video impression against me, let's say, might be less valuable for an advertiser than against, you know, a male audience. And so I think that what we'll see is the right audiences being more highly valued than audiences that are not as relevant to advertisers. So there we could even see almost very high CPMs for the right audience, but lower CPMs for the audience that doesn't matter for a given advertiser. So this dynamic pricing. And in terms of premium overall, I think that there is for the most premium inventory. There in 2012, we saw that demand really outstripped supply in many ways. If an advertiser really insisted on having that content, I think that we'll see more inventory become available in 2013. And pricing, pricing for the right audiences will go up. And you know, it's the beauty of big data is that it rewards stuff that works. So for the right inventory and the right content and the right audience, those publishers will be rewarded, and the advertisers will be also, because it's going to work. Brands are very much in this whole adventure, as you say. What has kept some advertisers away from programmatic buying across display and video has been, audience buying at its sort of core was really a performance-based value proposition. So brand marketers many, you know, consumer packaged good marketers, they weren't able to really find a way to make audience buying work for them. Now with video and the ability to bring data to the decision of whether or not to deliver a video impression against an audience, this gives a really strong value for brand advertisers. So what we are seeing now, and it will continue through next year, is many more brand advertisers getting on board. And they're asking us questions like, how can we use this? We know that this is something that we should be doing. How do we use it? And our answer is, it's always about, start with the audience and the objectives. The beauty of what we can do here, though, is start to plan video as part of the whole whole mix. So deliver a video ad the first time we see a user, and then the second time maybe we'll deliver a display ad, and then maybe the third time we'll deliver another ad that sort of is a call to action. So video as part of the funnel, and using sequencing of messaging through data across video and display is what is getting many of our brand advertisers very excited, and us as well.